ला इलाहा मौजूदुन, ला इलाहा मौजूदुन। ओके, नंबर टू, ला इलाहा फिल वजूदी। आर यू विथ मी? दीज आर द थिंग्स विच आर मैजूफ। देयर इज अ थर्ड वन विच आई प्रिफर, I think you will also feel that way. Dr. Abdurrahim showed me this, okay, brother and sister, when he was here last time. La ilaha yastahikul ibadata. Yastahikul ibadata. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? What is the verb here? Istahakka. Istahakka. Yastahikku. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Istahakka. Yastahikku. Okay. Deserves the worship. There is no deity in the category of deities. Deserves the worship except Allah. Brother and sisters, yastahiku. Where is the file? Mustatir. Takadiruhu? Huwa. And this huwa goes to? Illa. Okay? And this is mafulun bihi. And now, the badal is from ilah. This is the badal of ilah. Brothers and sisters, can you imagine? We, right now, do not understand the force and the power and the depth of this sentence. Very few people, brother. Most of the time, what do you hear? What do you hear the translation? There is no God but God. Brother, this is not the translation. You cannot even translate this. The closest translation will be, there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. That will be the closest translation. But even that does not give that punch. The people of Makkah and Medina and the Arabs in that time were very, very advanced in their language. They knew their language very well. So when Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, La ilaha illallahu, they understood the deeper meaning of it because it negated all their idols, all of them. In just one plain statement of four words, La ilaha illallah, in that four words it negated their whole concept, their thinking, which they have been entertaining for long, long time. Their forefathers, it negated them. That absolutely there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. They understood it, and that's why they did not like it. Because in this one statement, their whole religion, thinking, ideology was cancelled. And they opposed it. Because if they accepted it, it means that everything that they are doing has to stop. Okay? So that is the meaning, brother. They understood, but we did not understand. There was a student in one of my friend's class, brother and sister, when he was talking about this, La ilaha, the student said, Dr. Sam, Dr. Ahmad Shah, how is it that it is so easy to say La ilaha illallah and those people did not say? What wrong would have been for them to say La ilaha illallah, we accept it? Then the Dr. Ahmad Shah replied, it's easy for you because you do not understand the meaning. But for them, they knew the meaning and they would not accept it. Abu Lahab knew the meaning of La ilaha. If he accepted it, it means he has to give up everything. We do not understand the meaning. So for us, you know, the money is our deity. Money becomes our God. Our children, our family becomes our God. We forget the deity. That is our problem. For money's sake, I will tell lies, I'll cheat, I'll do everything. Because money to me is more important than God. I've made the money as my God. And so, in other words, we do not understand the meaning of La ilaha illallah. Means, in the category of deities, how many deities are there, brother? People worship fire, people worship stone, people worship animals, people worship trees, people worship mountains. So these are all their deities. And this statement, La ilaha illallah, there is absolutely, absolutely no deity worthy of worship except Allah. So there is a power and intensity in La nafiyatu lil jins. And we got to understand. Alhamdulillah, through our studies, we learn the deeper meaning of La ilaha. And remember, this concept of La nafiyatu lil jins does not exist in English and not even in other languages. That is why Arabic language is so beautiful, so powerful. And maybe that is the reason Allah chose to reveal His final book to all mankind till the end of time in Arabic. There is a wisdom. And so we got to learn. We learn everything in the world. Why not Arabic? For a short period of time so that we can understand at least the basic things in the Quran, brothers and sisters. We do not have to be a scholar of Arabic. Just enough Arabic so that we can read the Quran and understand, and we hear the Quran. It penetrates our hearts and our mind, brothers and sisters, and we feel the joy and the love, you know, that is there hidden in the Quran. And that will not come unless we learn the language, brothers and sisters. So I thought I should mention it to you in little bit detail, huh, brother? Remember that, inshallah. Because I love this concept. La an-nafiyatu lil jins. It doesn't exist, brother. And we must also remember, brother, Quran is the ultimate miracle. Everlasting miracle. Perpetual miracle. And it will remain miracle till the end of time. And take my word, it is never too late to learn Arabic. And one more sentence, you are never too old to learn Arabic. So we must all make an effort and learn Arabic, inshallah. Brother. And Allah will bless us. And Allah will make it easy on us, inshallah. Okay, brothers and sisters. هَذِهِ لَا النَّافِيَةُ لِلْجِنْسِ يُبْنَى إِسْمُهَا The ism is مَبْنِي. Brother, it is ism is mabni ala fatha. How will you describe it, brother? Ilaha ismu la nafiyatu lil jins mabni ala fatha. And then the khabar can be, you know, five kinds. You know, okay, fine, brothers and sisters. Wa dhalik idha kana mufradan. Okay, if it is mufrad, okay.